Welcome to Huerto Digital Solutions, Master Team Center in Minutes. In this tutorial, we'll unlock BMID secrets, revealing custom attributes, naming rules, and classic LOVs step by step. Want it faster? Bump the playback speed to 1.25x or 1.5x in settings. Like what you see? Hit like, subscribe, and let's dive in.
Hi everyone, today we're doing another video on Team Center, and this time the first thing that we're focusing in is the creation of new custom properties on an item. So as you may remember, last time we created an item called HDS4 wheel, and with that item it was created a revision called HDS4 wheel revision. That is this one right here. In this window, you can see all the information of the HDS4 wheel revision. But in this opportunity, we will only focus on the properties. We'll add some custom properties, seeing the different types of them. First, we'll add a long description. Which is basically a description that does not fit the usual amount of characters. So here we'll set 2000 characters and call this is a long description for the revision. All the other values will be set like this because it does not change anything for this matter. As we go on with the other properties, you will see how are they useful. We'll go on to next. Here are some properties operation, like getters and setters, that for this video, will leave like just like this. So as you see, the new property HDS4 long description has been created for the item HDS4 wheel revision. Now we'll add another property, let's say in this case of type integer. Some property relevant for a wheel of type integer may be the outer diameter of the wheel. This is the outer diameter of the wheel. And in this case, in the display name, we could add something useful for the user to see. For example, this is the outer diameter that is going to be entered in millimeters, let's say. As you can see, the name of the property is outer diameter, and the display name doesn't necessarily have to be the same name, let's say, but you could add some other stuff in order to be clear for the user. We'll click on finish. As we are talking about outer diameter, we could also add inner diameter. The same thing here, millimeter. And finish. So here we have the three new properties. Now we'll go on with another type of property, let's say the date. Maybe the approval date of the revision. And just to keep seeing the different types, we could go with Boolean, calling this property is obsolete, which means, as its name says, this represents if the revision is obsolete. And in this case, we're gonna use like an initial value. In this case, we'll set the initial value to false. So when a revision is created, the initial value will be false. And if sometime during the life cycle of this revision, someone decides to declare it as obsolete, they will need to set this value as true. So here we can see the different types of attributes. Now we're gonna go with still the same type of attributes, but this time doing a particular change. In this case, we're trying to include an email list. For example, this is an email list which users have to be notified when there's a change in the revision. We'll use this using this checkbox array. So with this, we'll be able to store the email list in an array so that it could be more organized, let's say. And this is my new attribute. Now we'll be going a step further. Let's say that we want to create a new property called, I don't know, color, which represents this is the color of the wheel. As you know, there's a defined set of colors that a wheel can have. For this matter, we're gonna use something called list of values, which are gonna call from now LOBs or LOVs, which are created right here. Here we have on the extensions window LOBs that can be classified in batch LOVs, classic love, and dynamic love. This video will only just focus on classic love. Create a new classic love, and here we'll call it like color love. What is this gonna be used for? This is gonna be used to make a list of colors from which the user has to select in order to be accepted, let's say. So we'll go on here and add like some colors, let's say, just for the matter of the example, the value is Y and the value display name is yellow. We'll leave it like that. We'll add value red. Green. So these are, let's say, these are the colors that a wheel can take. We create the love, as you can see, HDS for color love, and then we have to link them. Click on it and then go to this window that says love attaches, and add the new love that we just created. So we'll search my name, let's say HDS for color love. And now this property, HDS for color, is associated to this love, HDS for color love. So when the user tries to create a new item revision, he will have to select a color from this list of values. Now we'll go on with another topic in this video that is pretty important as well, and is the naming rules. As you may remember, the last time we created the wheel object from the rich client, we saw that the item was assigned an ID. The ID was like something like 0089 or 0090. I don't remember that well, but it was like an integer, let's say. We would like for this item to have like a code, let's say something like wheel 001, for example, for it to be more organized. Because if we see an item that is called 0089, it's not clear which type of item we're talking about. However, if we see an item that is called wheel 001, it's obvious that it's a wheel. So we'll now go on and do that. How can we do that? Using a naming rule. First, we're gonna go to the item HTS4 wheel properties and search the item ID. We'll click on it. And here there's a window that says naming rule attaches. Similarly to what we did with the love, we have to attach a naming rule. So we'll go on in this window right here where we can find the rules and naming rules. Create a new naming rule. We'll call it wheel ID, let's say. How do we define the patterns? We could see it right here using the help button and search for pattern. And here, as you can see, there is this very useful text that tells us how to define the different pattern. For example, the ampersand matches an alphabetic value or a numeric value. The end matches a numeric value. So in this time, we already know what type of pattern we want to make. So it's going to be called something like we and then, which is like the string we for wheel and six numbers. Put an initial value. Obviously, the initial value should be wheel 0000001, and the maximum value will be 0999999. So we'll click on finish and click on finish again. So the new naming rule is created, as we can see right here, and we'll go on to attach it. Naming rule, browse the new naming rule, which is this one. Finish, and this naming rule is now attached to the item ID. So we'll save our changes and now go to the deploy. So we'll go on just following the same steps as the first time. Generate software package, finish. Then we're gonna go and open the environment manager, configuration manager. Perform maintenance on an existing configuration. And here we're gonna click, instead of clicking add remove features, we're gonna click update database full model system downtime required, because this is the second time we do this deploy. The first time we clicked on add remove features. From now on, we'll click on update database full model. Next. Info DBA. And we're gonna select the new software package that we have generated, which is located in teacher root, BME, the workspace. And it's the last one of them, generated at 2242. We're gonna click on next and start the deploy. And now we'll have to wait until the deploy finishes. So now the installation has finished. We can see the changes on the Teamcenter Bridge client. Now we'll open the Bridge client and log in as InfoDBA. And we'll create a new item. Next. And now we'll see the new attributes that we have added. The probable date, I mean, we'll set them as 18th of March. The color will be yellow, let's say. We'll leave the email list like this. With the inner diameter, we'll put like 25, outer diameter 28, and long description. This is a description that could be longer. And assign an item revision ID. We'll click on finish. And the new item has been created with the new naming rule and the new custom properties. So, this is everything for this video. I hope you liked it, and goodbye.